students, today we are going to start with the previous topic, chapter number 2, land, soil, water, natural vegetation and wildlife. So we have already discussed about the two natural resources. Now in this lecture we are going to discuss about the third resource, and that is water. Water is a very important natural resource. We all need water to live. We cannot live without it. And do you know that in 1975 the consumption of water for human use was 3850 cubic kilometer per year, and it soared to more than 6000 cubic kilometer per year in the year 2000. So water is a very important natural resource. Now 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with water. We all know this, that 3/4 of our earth's surface is covered with water. And if we see our planet from the universe, then we can see that our earth is blue, and that is why it is also known as the blue planet or the watery planet. So it was in the primitive oceans that life began almost 8.5 billion years back, and fresh water is only about 2.7%. Nearly 70% of this water occurs as ice sheets and glaciers in Antarctica, Greenland and mountain regions, and fresh water accounts for only about 2.7%. And of this fresh water, 1% is only available and fit for human use, which is found as groundwater, surface water in the rivers and lakes, and as water vapor in the atmosphere. And we all know that water is used for different purposes. For example, instead of drinking, cooking, we use water for agriculture, for generating electricity, in the industries, everywhere water is required. Now, problems of water availability. There is scarcity of water in many regions of the world. Most of Africa, West Asia, South Asia, parts of Western USA, Northwest Mexico, South America, Australia, they all are facing the shortage in the fresh water supply. Countries those who are located in climatic zones, they are most susceptible to the droughts and they face great problems of water scarcity. Now the countries which are facing the problems of water shortage, they are facing the problems of water scarcity. They are more prone to water scarcity. Therefore, water shortage, it may be a consequence of changes in the seasonal or annual rainfall, or the scarcity is caused by overexploitation or contamination of the water sources. We all know that we overuse the water resources. For example, if we are brushing our teeth, we keep the tap open. So this is wastage of water. So because of these small wastages, so much water resources are going to be finished off. So it is our duty that we have to solve this problem of water availability, and we have to conserve the water resources. So the question is, how we can conserve the water resources? So access to the clean and enough water resources is a major problem facing the world today. Discharge of untreated or partially treated sewage, agricultural chemicals, industrial effluents in water bodies, they are major contaminants. So most of these chemicals, they all are non-biodegradable and they reach human bodies through water. See, when the industries, they are throwing all their industrial waste into the water bodies, the water is being polluted. So all the rivers, all the water bodies, lakes, small ponds, they all are being polluted or contaminated when people or human beings, they are throwing everything into these water bodies. So water pollution can be controlled if we treat all these effluents daily before releasing them in water bodies. If the industries, they are properly treat the water before, or they are which is grown without the help of human beings. Means it is grown in the mountains, hills or any other area, and human beings, they are not interfering in that vegetation or in their growth. So natural vegetation and wildlife, it exists only in the narrow zone of contact between the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere, and all these three things together we call it as biosphere. So in the biosphere, all the living beings, they all are interrelated and interdependent on each other for their survival. And this life supporting system is known as ecosystem. So in our ecosystem, plants and animals, they both are interrelated to each other and interdependent upon each other. And this process, or you can say this system, is known as ecosystem. Now vegetation and wildlife, they all are valuable resources. There are many uses of plants. Wildlife includes animals, birds, insects, as well as aquatic life forms. They provide us meat, mites and wood. Insects like bees, they provide us honey. They help in pollination of flowers and they have an important role to play as decomposers in the ecosystem. So we all know that vegetation and wildlife, they are very important for us. there may be balance